Let's play the first chord. Yes. 13. 13. Thank you. 13. For good luck on Halloween, we play number 13. Play and sustain the first chord, everyone. Conversations must cease. Here we are. We have N. Breathe. Many sweeps, but we can get both. Let's play a couple of bars of it. Put air through the instrument. You've got to take air in and really put out for the brass like a wall of air, and for the woodwinds, it's an intense scream. Right here. Here we are. All right. Dancing in the back. We have an already pre-party for this. We have three and four and. Straight 16th notes, everyone. All 12 16th notes under our nice and light, bouncy. Use the same airflow as the long tones. Here we are. We have three and a four and. Until the fourth beat of the bar. Three, four, one. Put it in the correct place. All right. Now we're going to have duplet week, and we're going to get cute right away. We're going to play the first two 16th notes, and then only every other one after that. Dup, 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 dup. You know what? You have an idea what we're doing? All right. Let's try it slowly once just to make sure. So let me just play it. Or it's in B flat. So, you play the first two, and then it's off beats until you change on beat one. I will beat it out so you can watch and see where beat one is if you somehow get confused. Here we are. We have one, and two, and three, and four, and. Okay, that's the idea, except you should be together and not playing the riffs. Let's do it again. Now you know what it is. We have three and four and. There's something over here in bassoons and saxophones that's just a little behind in general. I noticed this when I was listening back to last week's. So try to be right on top of the beat. One more time. Got to get through at least three bars where it's super, super tight. We have three and four and. Thank you. clarinets. Some of you are struggling with when you get up to G. You're getting a lot of that kind of sound instead of. Remember, you got to get the air to the reed. You got to deliver it to the reed using the shape of the tongue. Like almost like not that will give you that sound. Tongue's got to be high. Like you're making a wind tunnel inside your mouth against between the tongue and the roof of the mouth. If the tongue is low, that's when you get that sound. Okay? I don't want to go through the whole thing with that exact same pattern one more time, but I do want to do it a little bit because the next step is a variation of that. So can we do that same thing one more time? No faster. And then I'm going to do that one faster and see what happens. So I need concentration. And you got to control your instrument, but the instrument cannot control you, nor can it decide when the notes start. You must decide when the notes start. Here we go. You have three and four and. When you think and count and concentrate. Okay, we're going to change one thing only. Okay, we're just adding an extra note. That's all it is. Instead of duck, duck. All right, we got to get a little virtuosity going here. So make sure, before you play those three fast notes, that the air is drawn in and the tongue is behind the air. H-U-T. Yeah, and it's like a crescendo through those three notes. Here we go. Same tempo. Clarity, or I stop. We have three and four and. I will slow it down to practice it, but this is what I hear. It sounds like that, okay? And not that every one of you sounds like that, but the totality of it. So in order to get it to sound the way you want it, everyone has to exaggerate the space between the notes and the clarity and action of the tongue. That's, again, without the instrument, the air is, first of all, very well prepared behind the tongue, and then it goes through. Okay? Can we try it a little slower at this? And really, really exaggerate the shortness, but use air. Here we are at this tempo. Three and four and. You've got to play together for it to work. And some of you had no H. You do it's like that. Remember, brass players, the air violently enters the mouthpiece. That's what Arban says. So you have to do that. Got to have air prepared. Here we go. We have three and four and. So now we're gonna change that, and we're gonna play the first three 16th notes of the bar, and then in each of the succeeding beats, we'll only play the middle two. All right, so it's like this. Okay, simple enough. So, two 16th notes rest in between each pair of notes. You've got to think back to where we started, which is... If you think of that... Rest. Then it's easy. All right, let's try it. See if we can get it on the first go. Then we got to change scales at some point. Actually, let's go ahead and change to number 14 as long as we're doing it. This is 14 with that pattern. We have 3 and 4. And... rigidly straight, because that's also bad, but gently and in a relaxed manner, straight up and down with your head resting on top of your shoulders, you can get a really good breath that way. Okay, let's do the same thing a little faster, please. Here we go. We have 1, and we need a full concentration. 1, 2, 3, and 4, and... beats 2 and 4, we're going to play the last three. We only have those two little rests. Now, you will notice musically what I'm doing is using those three upbeat notes on 2 and 4 to drive musically to the main beat. That will help you also with the sound and the articulation. That's what you have to do. You don't have to exaggerate it quite as much as I did, but it will help by giving yourself a musical direction to solve the technical problem of playing 7 fast notes. 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 6 fast notes. Okay, here we go. Same scale. Let's do it. We'll do it a little slower just so you get used to the pattern. Here we go. We have 3 and 4 and 2. The two little rests, the sound doesn't have as good a shape as the first note that happens on the downbeat. It sounds softer and not as confidently struck with the articulation. You have to say them to have the same H-U-T and prepared air. Okay? So really let it explode out of there. Confidence in exactly where you're going to place it will help.
It will help.
Believe me. Here we go. Same people. Same place. We have three and four and. Everyone, got to really think about this, and I want it to be together. It really isn't that fast. We should do it really fast, but maybe another time. Let's see how good you are. Here we go. We have three and. Simple, I'll just play it for you. That's simple enough. Do I have to spell it out exactly what that is? There's just two 32nd notes on the second of each first and third beat, and then you only play the first note of the second and fourth beat. And then you change. Let's do it slowly once. Clarity. Separate short notes. Here we go. Three and four and. Okay, this is what it sounds like. It sounds like you breathe down to about here. Nothing will ever happen if you breathe like a very, very old person. Not old person like me old. I mean like that old, okay? Or you're breathing. That's what it sounds like, okay? You can do better, yep. Yeah, no good. You hear how the first note pops out of the instrument? That's just H-U-T, that's all it is. So without the instrument, there's a crescendo of air through there. If you don't use it, you will not get those notes to speak. Let's do it slower than that, please. Use some air. Breathe it in. Blast it out. Here we go. We have three and four and. Please count the rest properly also. You can also watch me. I'll show you where it starts. Do better. Better. Three and four and. That's better. Can we actually have space each note? Because it's thump, blah, 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 sort of sounds like you're trying to talk too fast and everything comes out. Blah, 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 blah. You know, you have to clarify it. And if you can't, then it's got to be long-term homework, because you can't fix this in an hour. You've got to fix it in weeks and months. Here we go. You have three, and, four, and. 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 First note. Makes it a little more technical, and it increases your reliance on your airstream. Okay, if you can tongue this fast, then it shouldn't be a problem. You should feel down here the compression. Yeah, for some of the instruments, you have so much pushback already, right? But from the small reed. But the others, you just have to really got to power that air through there, like Superman with his hurricane breath, okay? It's got to be like that. There are a lot of Superman references. I wish I had read the comics more recently. I read them when I was very, very young. I don't remember everything about Superman. I know he has some issues. Here we go. Number 16, that pattern, please. And make sure those little teeny notes are cleaved apart from each other. No notes holding hands. It's not a romantic evening. It's Halloween. Here we go. We have three and four and. But you still must count the rest. And if you watch, I will show you where the next one starts. And that will alleviate your having to guess. Here we go. We have three and four air. Thank you.